In the early church, we read in Acts 2, the church met together every day in the temple courts and in their homes. Meeting in the temple courts means they met out in public. They came together in public. They were in temple courts so women could be there too. They also met in their homes, not quite as public, but still something easily observed. It might seem like Acts 2 is wildly different from our time, but stick with me a minute. I want to point out just how dangerous that was. If they were caught meeting together, it could very well mean they'd forfeit their lives. They would end up in a Roman arena with either a lion, a bear, or a gladiator, all of which would prove fatal. Did they stop meeting together? No. They knew they needed the encouragement and love shared when people come together. Now, we can debate if there are parallels between being fed to lions and the coronavirus, but that doesn't seem fruitful to me. Here's the point I want you to get. We can't get by on a once-a-week faith, especially when going through difficult times. I want you to have a daily faith, where every single day you wake up and spend some time with God. If you have family living in your house at this time of shelter in place, then have devotions with them. Build each other up in the faith. Wherever you find yourself, gather together with anyone else who's with you. Pray, study God's word, seek his face, lift up his name. Share the blessings you've received with each other so we can have an everyday faith. Scripture says in Acts 2, every day they continue to meet together in the temple courts. They broke bread in their home and ate together with glad and sincere hearts, praising God and enjoying the favor of all the people. What's it say happened next? The Lord added daily those who were being saved. With all my heart, I believe God will use this time in the world when people are afraid. They will look to Him, and we will see daily people being born into the kingdom of God. Because we're not like this world. We live by faith and not by fear.